Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX were preparing to launch and got all the way up to the propellant load of the Crew 6 mission. However, they had to scrub the launch due to an issue with the ignition fluid for Falcon 9. They tweeted, "Standing down from tonight's launch of Crew 6 due to a TTEB ground system issue. Both Crew 6 and the vehicles are healthy and propellant offload has begun ahead of the crew disembarking Dragon. So, with the delay to the Crew 6 mission due to the TTEB issue, here's a look at when we can expect the next launch attempt. The Crew 6 mission is currently scheduled to lift off tomorrow, Thursday 2nd at 5:34 AM UTC or 12:34 AM EST. We can also hopefully expect a Starlink mission to launch tomorrow. The Starlink 27 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 2nd at 6:52 PM UTC or 1:52 PM EST. On Monday, SpaceX did launch a Starlink mission containing their new Starlink V2 satellites with the Starlink 6-1 mission.
One, ignition, and liftoff. 6-1.
The booster which launched this mission, B1076, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Stage 1 has lit one engine to prepare for landing on our drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas. This final burn slows down the rocket to help it stick the landing on the drone ship.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing deploy.
Great feedback from our team there, and of course, beautiful views confirming that we have successfully landed stage 1.
I wanted to share this cool video from Elon Musk of the Starlink satellites from this mission being deployed. SpaceX posted a bunch of tweets with information about their V2 satellites that I wanted to share. The first says we call them V2 Mini. They represent a step forward in Starlink capability. In response to this, they also posted a couple more tweets. The next says V2 Minis include key technology such as more powerful phased array antennas and the use of E-band for backhaul, which will allow Starlink to provide approximately 4 times more capacity per satellite than earlier iterations. Then they posted, "This means Starlink can provide more bandwidth with increased reliability and connect millions of more people around the world with high-speed internet." There was another tweet posted with more information related to these satellites. It says, among other enhancements, V2 Minis are equipped with new argon Hall thrusters for on-orbit maneuvering. Then, in response to this, they posted a couple more tweets. The first of these responses says, "Developed by SpaceX engineers, they have 2.4 times the thrust and 1.5 times the specific impulse of our first-gen thrusters. This will also be the first time ever that argon Hall thrusters are operated in space." Then finally, they also posted argon Hall thruster tech specs, 170 Nm thrust, 2500 second specific impulse, 50% total efficiency, 4.2 kilowatt power, 2.1 kilogram mass, center mounted cathode. In response to a tweet from Everyday Astronaut about rocket engines, Musk posted a tweet with info on Raptor. He said, "Raptor's start is now reliable on the test stand under most conditions. Now we are working on dynamically adapting the start sequence based on increasingly difficult propellant inlet pressures and temperatures. Operating with low pressure, warm liquid oxygen is particularly important." On Monday, SpaceX performed some further cryogenic testing of Starship 26 on the Pad A test mount. Yesterday, Chris Burgin also posted his tweet with Starship 26 having been lifted off of the test mount. It says, "Ship 26 has been removed from Pad A and is set to be transported away from the launch site." There was also another Ship 26 related tweet posted by Chris. It says, "Ship 26 has returned to the production site and is back with its naked pal Ship 27. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.